It is day two of competition here in Almaty at the 28th Winter Universiad, and winter definitely came today. Snow all over the region. We will head off and take a look at alpine skiing, the women's alpine combined slalom portion. Speed skating will be the men's 5,000 meters from Madeu. In snowboard, it'll be the parallel slalom, both women's and men's finals. Freestyle skiing, it's the mixed teams aerials, biathlon, the men's individual 20 kilometers, and in hockey, Slovakia takes on the USA. Very beautiful day here in Shimbaluk Ski Resort outside of Almaty. Lots of snow on this day, as you can see. And it actually forced postponement of the Super G portion of this ladies' alpine combined. It will take place on February 1st. But the slalom was able to take place despite the heavy snow. First up, this is Veronica Olivieri of Italy. She will set the pace here. And you can see just how much snow is falling, and visually very difficult to see even at the top of the course. 57.16 seconds for Olivieri, the first racer down the hill. Now here is Daria Ovchinnikova of Russia. A little bit of trouble on those early gates, and that puts her a second and a quarter behind Olivieri. She managed to make up a little bit of time, but still 65 100s back. Now Anastasia Salantova of Russia. This her hero as American skier Lindsey Vonn. And she is well ahead of Olivieri's pace at the interval. Continues to carve her way down through those gates, across the finish line. She gained more time on the bottom half of the course. 1.17 seconds ahead. Now Petra Smaldore of Italy. Trying now to catch Salantova. 0.7 of a second behind at the interval. And she'll lose ground on the bottom half, finishing almost a second back. Now Barbara Kantarova of Slovakia. She was fifth in the Super G on January 30th, competed in the Sochi Olympics. Did not finish in the slalom, but also competed there in the giant slalom and the Super G. It's her second Universiad. She was in Trentino back in 2013. And she will come in 3/4 of a second back of Salantova, who continues to set the pace. Now Maria Shkanova of Belarus. She was eighth in the Super G on the 30th of January. Her third Universiad, seventh in the slalom in 2015 in Granada, 14th in 2013 in Trentino, and she will set the new pace. Just over 3/4 of a second faster than Salantova. Now we'll look at Desiree Ilec of Slovenia. Trying now to catch the Belarusian. Belarusian's time, 56.78 seconds. And Ilets will finish nearly 2 seconds back. So Shkanova of Belarus sets the fastest pace in the slalom. There you see the times. They will race the Super G tomorrow on February 1st. From the beautiful Medeu Sports Complex, outside of Almaty, you get a great look at it there, this outdoor oval. It is the men's 5,000 meters. Lots of snow on this day, so some of the hardest working people are those trying to shovel to keep the ice clear. We'll look here now at Linus Heidegger of Austria up against Saitoro Ichinoue of Japan. There's Heidegger. Dutch skaters have really dominated this event at Universiad, winning 4 gold all time. Speed skating, of course, not competed at every Universiad, depending on whether the host has a venue that can work or not. And luckily for us here in Almaty, they do, and it's a spectacular setting. And there you see Heidegger. Currently 8.5 seconds ahead of the leader's pace, trying to fend off Ichinoue. There you see some of the shoveling going on in the background, even as the athletes move around the oval. Ichinoue starting to inch his way closer to Heidegger. Ichinoue had a personal best of 6 minutes, 28.76 seconds in Nagano last November. He won't hit that today, but he temporarily moves into first place. Heidegger is in second. Now it's Lee Jin-yong of Korea on the inside lane and Davide Giotto of Italy in the outside. And Giotto here in the early going, ahead of the pace set by Ichinoue. Giotto is only 3 days removed from his personal best in Berlin in a time of 6 minutes, 27.73 seconds. That took place at an ISU World Cup event. Now Giotto falling a little behind that pace set by the Japanese skater Ichinoue. And the shoveling continues here as the snow continues to come down very heavily. Now Giotto falling further behind that leader's pace. But as he hits the bell lap, Giotto, as you can see, he's found another gear well ahead of that pace set by Ichinoue. And he crosses the finish line in a time of 6 minutes, 51.64 seconds. And there you see the Korean laboring a little bit as he comes and crosses the line. So Davide Giotto of Italy wins gold here in the men's 5,000 meters. Saitoro Ichinoue, he will settle for silver. 1.3 seconds back, and Linus Heidegger of Austria, 3.82 seconds back, will win the bronze. And there you see the three medalists in the men's 5,000 meters. We head up into the mountains to the Shimbalek Ski Resort just outside of Almaty. It is snowboard competition, the parallel slalom, both men and women. It's only been competed once at Universiad, back in Zakopane in 2001. On the women's side then, the gold medal is won by Blanka Izalonis. Here's the small final second race between Canadian Jennifer Hochrig and Pole Carolina Schottfisch. The Pole won the bronze medal yesterday in the parallel giant slalom. And Hochrig actually goes down. You won't even see her come through the finish line. So it ends up being a very easy win for the Pole. And there you see the two of them. And now to the men's small final. This is Oleksandr Belinsky of Ukraine and Vladimir Karamshin. And Belinsky, who also won the bronze yesterday in the giant slalom, works his way down through this course. You can see the intense snow, and he will win this bronze medal over Karamshin of Russia. Almost a second ahead to take that third place medal. Now to the women's final. This is Veronika Biela of Poland and Maggie Kerrigan of the United States. This is the first run of two. The second one, they'll just switch sides. As they make their way down through these very snowy conditions. Biela was fourth in the parallel giant slalom yesterday. And she'll win this opening race by 41 hundredths of a second. And there's the second race. You'll see that Kerrigan's gate opens just a split second behind. That is the 42 100ths that she'll have to make up. And a bit of a tough turn there for Kerrigan, and Biela sees that she's well ahead and just has to stay on her feet through these final gates. Almost loses an edge there, but maintains her balance, and she will come across to win the gold medal quite easily. So Izalonis back in 2001, and Biela here in 2017. Two Polish snowboarders have claimed both parallel slalom gold medals on the women's side. Now to the men's final. This is Bogdan Bogdanov of Russia and Oskar Kwiatkowski of Poland. It was Christian Hanselmann of Switzerland who won the gold medal back in 2001. Bogdanov won the giant slalom yesterday, and he will win this first race of the big final and holds a 36 100ths of a second lead into the second run. Kwiatkowski has some work to do to get himself back into gold medal contention. But you can see Bogdanov on the blue course carving his way quite easily here. And he will easily come across to win this gold medal for Russia. So he wins both the slalom here today and the giant slalom yesterday. Kwiatkowski wins silver. Belinsky will take the bronze medal for Ukraine. It is mixed team aerials from the Mishas course at Tabagan here in Kazakhstan. This event has only been competed twice at Universiade. First in Harbin in 2009, where China won gold, and then now here in Almaty. There you see the second final. First up, Zhu Yingying. She won gold in yesterday's women's aerials final. Here she goes for her attempt in the final. And oh, really difficult spill for her. Just could not complete that final rotation. And you see the tips of her skis come right into the snow. Now with a back full. This is Zhu Nuo of China. She was the flag bearer for China in the opening ceremony. Sixth in the women's aerials yesterday. And the same fate for her. Just failing to complete that rotation, and the tips of her skis hit hard on the snow, and you'll get a good look at it here as that ski just pops right up. She appears to be okay, but a really tough fall. Now a back lay full for Kazakhstan too. This is Zhanbota Aldabergenova. Sixth in the women's aerials at the Sochi Olympics and bronze yesterday here. She lands it, a great tough landing for her. And so through the first run, Kazakhstan with a huge lead. Now Guo Zhiming, bronze in yesterday's men's aerials final. And he holds the landing. Falls to his back a little bit, a little disappointed, you can see there. But he is able to get back to his feet. He would score 64.86. Now here's Shi Haito, fourth yesterday in the men's aerials. Lands that one really well. Good score for him, 91.29. That would be the highest score in this final. Now a back full for Kazakhstan's Banglang Enkerbek. He too was at the Sochi Olympics. 21st in the first qualifying round and 13th in the second, so he failed to move on each time. Sticks the landing very well, and that'll secure gold for Kazakhstan on home soil. Alda Berganova and Enkerbek with an overall total of 167.05 will take gold. And there you see, in slow motion, as he lands very well to secure top spot on the podium. So Kazakhstan 2 wins gold. China 1 with Zhu Nuo and Shi Haito will take silver. And Zhu Yingying and Guo Zhiming will pick up the bronze medal. And there you see the Kazakhstan athletes at the top of the podium, much to the delight of their fans here in Tabagan. From the Alatau Cross Country Skiing and Biathlon Complex, it is the men's 20-kilometer biathlon individual event. And as you can see, very snowy conditions in the Almaty region today. Temperature, though, quite nice, around freezing at 0 degrees. There you get a look at the start list. Defending champion Dmytro Ruzanov of Ukraine is in the field here today trying to defend his gold medal. There you see racer number 21, Semin Suchilov of Russia. Followed 6 skiers later, there's Baptiste Jouty of France. And now Jouty, his first shooting sequence. One penalty for him. Good crowd on hand as they deal with the snowy conditions. Now, Sergei Korostilev of Russia from the standing position. No penalties for him. There is Korostilev making his way up one of the few hills here on this course. We'll now go to Jouty. Jouty in the prone position, his third shooting sequence, and he goes clean. Now back to Suchilov here at the just past the 14 kilometer mark. Korostilev, he goes clean from the prone position. You get a look at pair Victor Olsen. Now back to Suchilov, one penalty for him. His fourth shooting round. Jouty in his fourth shooting round, one penalty for him as well. Good battle here between the two Russians and the Frenchman Jouty. And there's Suchilov trying to catch countryman Ivanov, and he will. Temporarily putting him in first place. now Zhuti. He will surpass Suchilov, the time of 1 hour, 3 minutes, 41 seconds. There you get a good slow motion look at the Frenchman Zhuti. Now Korostalev, they're in bib number 37. He will not catch Zhuti on this day, finishing 41 seconds behind, but that will be good enough to give him a silver medal. And there you see the final standings. Zhuti with gold, Korostalev silver, Suchilev the bronze, and there the Frenchman. Dmytro Ruzanov, defending champion, finishes 14th on the day, does not defend his gold medal. It ends up in the hands of Baptiste Zhuti, who then brings up Korostalev and Suchilev, silver and bronze medalists respectively, to join him on the podium. There, your medalist in the men's 20 kilometer individual biathlon. From the Holick Arena, it's Group B men's ice hockey competition. Slovakia taking on the United States. Slovakia opened the tournament with a 9-0 win over Great Britain. And the Americans fell yesterday to Canada 6-0. You get a look at the standings there early in the tournament in Group B. And there you see Slovakia in blue and the Americans in white. Slovakian head coach Andrej Vibo. And there's the starting lineup. Peter Putec will get the start in goal. And for Sean Hogan, he'll go with Joseph Olin. And there you see Olin making his first appearance of the tournament. And underway, big game for the Americans. They try to even their record at 500. But an early power play for Slovakia, and it's Martin Unak. Rips the wrister past Olin, and Slovakia on the power play takes a 1-0 lead. 17 seconds later, bad turnover by the Americans. Great pass there from Brezhniak to Ivan Jakubik. Had a hat trick in the opener against Britain, and he gets his fourth goal of the tournament right here. Great hesitation. Olin had no chance after that turnover. But the Americans do respond. Uglum with the pass there in front ends up off the skates of Taylor Herndon and between the pads of Putec, and the Americans head into the intermission down 2-1. Slovakia though would keep pressing in the second period. Tomczak here with that backhander off the post. And there you see head coach Hogan talking to his troops. And then on a Slovakian two-man advantage, Unak with a shot easily stopped by Olin. That one was going well wide, as you could see. But after that two-man advantage, Peter Gappa rifles one over the blocker side of Olin. Get a great look at it there. Gappa looks off and then fires that wrister over the arm of Olin. Slovakia keeps coming. Another chance there by Piatchka denied. And the Americans head to the third period down 3-1. Early in the third, Opilka with a chance, bobbled initially there by Putec. But Tyler Opilka's attempt is thwarted. That one there off the post, right from the faceoff. Piatchka didn't miss by much. Here for the Americans, McGing with a chance in tight, but he's bowled over by Gabor. After some great board work by the Slovakians, Brezhniak will put that one into the open net, and Slovakia will secure a 4-1 win over the United States. They move to 2-0 on the tournament. Will take on Canada on February 3rd. For the Americans, they now fall to 0-2, and their next game will be against Great Britain. They see the final stats, shots. U.S. outshoots Slovakia 30-28, but it's not enough as they fall 4-1.